Hey guys, David here, and in the previous video about the Wii HD, I mentioned the possibility of a Rockstar game, most notably Grand Theft Auto 5, coming to the next Nintendo system. I reported on this rumor from a French website, but technically there was another blog that had it before it, it's just that blog is sort of seen as less reliable. So I didn't give much attention to the story until it popped up on the French website, because they actually have a history of, you know, getting leaks correct. That said, it might give a bit more weight to these other rumors on this other blog, so I'm going to run through some of the other stuff they say might be happening. Just remember though, take this with a massive grain of salt. We don't really know if any of this is true at all, like even the Rockstar rumor could be way off. So a few days ago, Edge magazine had one of the first rumors about the Wii HD that said major developers already have development kits. They singled out a few developers, including Ubisoft, Electronic Arts, and Activision. This other blog though is saying that a bunch of other developers have the development kits, including Square Enix, Capcom, Sega, Rockstar / Take-Two, and Namco. What might get people excited though is that apparently a Star Fox game is in early development. And that's definitely not incredibly surprising because obviously Star Fox 64 is about to come onto the 3DS, so it makes sense that Nintendo would want to work on something original for the home console. And one thing I actually mentioned on the blog recently is that Nintendo has been co-developing and outsourcing a lot of the development work as of late. For instance, with Ocarina of Time 3D, they're not even handling that development. They offloaded a lot of the work to a company known as Grezzo, and that's like their biggest franchise. Or at least one of their biggest. It's one of their most prized games, and they're getting another company to work on it. And the same thing's happening with Paper Mario and Pilotwings Resort and Steel Diver and all these other games. Nintendo aren't directly working on them. And they're also not working on many Wii games. You know, really, Skyward Sword is the only Wii game in development. At least the only notable Wii game in development. So it really does seem like Nintendo have all these development teams working on Wii HD games. Because it really explains why there's nothing else is getting made. Anyways, other games that might be in development according to these rumors, because remember, these are rumors. So one of them would be Resident Evil, so that'd be from Capcom, obviously. And that's not too hard to believe because Capcom is working on Resident Evil for the 3DS, and the port of Resident Evil 4 was considered one of the best games on the Wii in the early days. And in a similar vein, apparently Kojima, the guy that made Metal Gear Solid, has been approached about the Wii successor. Seeing as Metal Gear Solid is coming out in the 3DS, it wouldn't be too shocking for that to happen. Of course, though, that's sort of the problem with all these rumors, is that it seems to be based on what's happening with the 3DS. Which makes sense from Nintendo's perspective, like they don't want to have to keep reinventing the wheel, it's best just to go after the developers they already have a relationship with. But it also makes you wonder if this site has just taken what Nintendo's done with the 3DS, and then sort of try to bring it to the Wii just to grab attention. But anyways, the last couple of rumors from the site is that Retro is working on a Wii successor game, but it's not related to Metroid. But maybe they're working on a new Donkey Kong Country game, something like that? No idea really. And finally, the site mentions the most common form of speculation related to the Wii HD, and that's that Skyward Sword might be pushed back. Obviously, Skyward Sword is a Wii game at the moment, but people are thinking it might be a similar situation with Twilight Princess. So with Twilight Princess, the game was delayed for about a year, and then came out in the Wii before it was released on the GameCube. That obviously annoyed a lot of people, but it made for a very good launch. Pretty much everyone who bought a Wii bought Twilight Princess. And while that sort of contradicts Nintendo's strategy of giving the focus to third parties at launch, it doesn't change the fact that putting Skyward Sword on the new platform would get more people to buy that platform. Anyways though, like I said, all rumors, have to keep pointing out rumors, speculation, just have fun with all this stuff, don't take it too seriously. The thing I love about having a new system that we know nothing about is that we can have all those wild guesses and just have fun with it. But anyways, of course, leave your thoughts below. What do you want to see on the Wii HD? Do you think these rumors are full of crap? Just let me know. It's all good fun. But I'll talk to you later.